Okay, we heard you. You're excited about 9.1, and so are we. We're so excited that we've been nerding out and theory crafting some early tier lists for the new patch, and today we bring you our predictions for ranged DPS in the new Season 2 meta. But as a huge disclaimer, this tier list is just a prediction. It is impossible to know for sure how the season will play out, but our team of pro players gave us some insight into how things will shape up this patch. So buckle up as we break down the best ranged DPS for patch 9.1. As always though, we have a quick question for you. Have you played any arena yet this patch? What are your initial thoughts? Let us know what you think in the comments below. Also, if you're looking to increase your rating this season, be sure to check us out at skillcap.com/wow. Over the years, we have seen people go from Challenger to Gladiator all by implementing the lessons we teach in our videos. In fact, we are so confident in your results that we offer a 6-month money-back guarantee if you don't gain at least 250 rating after using our site. Our class courses teach you the fundamentals you need to master your class in PvP, and we have hundreds of exclusive commentaries featuring matchup breakdowns directly from the best players in the world. You'll also gain premium access in our Discord server, where our team of pros respond to all questions asked. Sign up today for as little as $4.99 a month if you're serious about improving. Do you know who's looking pretty good this patch? BM Hunters. What a surprise. Yes, the spec that requires the most skill in the game will have even more skill to kill you with in Season 2, getting a bunch of new PvP talents that will knock the socks right off of you. Some of the new class-wide PvP talents include Tranquilizing Darts, which will decrease enemy buffs by 4 seconds whenever Trank Shot or Counter Shot are used. This is pretty much a Resto Druid counter since it will completely strip a target of HOTS. And on top of this, they will be getting Chimeral Sting, which will chain a slow, silence, and healing reduction into one another. Wild Kingdom is also the last class-wide addition to the PvP talent system, which will allow hunters to swap their current pet out WWE tag team style, potentially preventing it from being killed in some matchups where teams focus pets. And if you thought BM Hunter damage couldn't get any better, boy, were you wrong. The Beast Within has been redesigned to now include an attack speed increase on top of immunity to fear and horror effects, making it absolutely broken into teams with warlocks and priests. BM isn't the only god of Season 1 making his glorious return, as Fire Mage is also in the lineup for S-tier specs in 9.1. The spec is seeing some moderate nerfs, with Kindling and Infernal Cascade both being toned down. This will decrease the frequency of combustion in arena while slightly reducing its damage. The removal of Kleptomania will also hurt Fire Mages a bit, but comes with some new PvP talents. Ring of Fire is being added to the game, which looks really flashy, but probably won't see much play outside of RBGs since it will probably break CC in Arena. Fire will also be a huge benefactor to the expanded Soulbind system, as it will now have another auto-proc defensive called Waking Dreams that will make it even tankier on top of Cauterize and Triune Ward. All in all though, the spec is fundamentally the same at its core. It has the most CC options in the game, combined with an easily executable win condition. Expect to see Fire alongside Frost in many mage comps during Season 2. Staying gracefully on the S tier since our last update, we have Elemental Shaman. One of its biggest weaknesses is finally addressed, with Control of Lava offering some actual dispel protection. Now, Control of Lava will make Flame Shock dispels cause a massive eruption of fire damage on top of a knockback effect. This will help with a huge flaw in Shaman damage, since many healers can just spam dispel Flame Shocks to reduce damage on Lava Burst. This comes with another new talent called Seasoned Winds, which will give damage reduction on spell schools when casts are interrupted with Wind Shear. This will be absolutely broken into comps like Shadow Play, where there is only one school of damage being cast by the enemy team. Or into Demon Hunters, since their chaos damage like I-Beam counts as every spell school, giving multiple damage decreases. There are two new PvP talents also getting added into the mix, with a gimmicky static field totem that causes an AoE prison around targets unless killed, and Unleash Shield, which honestly won't be utilized much since Elemental doesn't really have many free PvP talent slots. And although these new PvP talents aren't that exciting, having Dispel Protection with Control of Lava will be massive and will likely keep Elemental on the S tier this season. And finally, rounding out the S tier are Shadow Priests, who will be one of the hardest specs to forecast on this tier list. The spec is seeing some damage buffs to Shadow Word, Pain, and Vampiric Touch, but these are being offset a bit by a nerf to Devouring Plague. This comes with a removal of the Lasting Plague PvP talent, which was a massive contributor to Shadow Priest damage in Season 1. With the PvP talent rework came some new and honestly weird options for Shadow Priests, including Megalomania, which will literally grant them the Surrender to Madness talent, allowing them to deal more damage and cast while moving, and Void Volley, which will launch some Shadow Crystals in the air every time Void Form is entered. This is one of many environmental damage abilities being added in the patch, which honestly feels like a PvE boss mechanic more than anything else. Finally, Improved Mass Dispel is being added as another option, giving Shadow Priests a really easy way to get clutch MD casts off in Arena. Existing PvP talents have also been reworked with a buff to Psyfiend HP, a nerf to Greater Fade, and PvP mana regeneration being reduced by 10%. Once again, all of these changes make it really hard to predict how strong Shadow will be in Season 2. We're putting it on the S tier for now, since many of its complementary classes are getting huge buffs, with Frost Mages, Warlocks, Feral Druids, and Warriors all staying really strong going into 9.1. Moving on to the A tier is a familiar face, with Balanced Druid staying strong for Season 2. The spec had a few of its PvP talents reworked, and they are looking really promising. Owlkin Adept will cause Owlkin Frenzy procs to increase the casting speed of Cyclone and Entangling Roots by 50%, something which might help carry the class in a fast-paced meta. This comes with a reworked High Winds talent, which will now also cause a 30% healing reduction on targets on top of its current effect. These new talents come with some nerfs to survivability, however, as Well-Honed Instincts, Frenzied Regeneration, and the Celestial Guardian PvP talent have all been nerfed in 9.1. This might encourage more druids to pick up Necrolord as their covenant, as it is already best for Resto and Feral, especially considering that the balance of all things legendary has been nerfed considerably, which was one of the main reasons Night Fae was so dominant in Season 1. There were some additional PvE talent nerfs this patch, but those hardly matter outside of Mythic Dungeons and RBGs. All in all, Balanced Druids are shaping up to be as good as they were last season and are more or less the same design. Hanging on to the A tier is Frost Mages, who got some pretty sweet buffs in 9.1. The biggest change is a damage increase to Frostbolt, which will now deal 100% increased damage in PvP. This will be a massive boost to their sustained damage and will actually make them fairly threatening. This comes with a slight nerf to Deep Shatter and a buff to Burst of Cold, but regardless, expect to see way more Frost Mages in PvP. Along with these damage buffs, they have a really unique PvP talent option called Ice Wall, which can be used to summon an actual pillar in Arena. It can be destroyed, but functions exactly as a line of sight barrier. The only thing really hurting Frost Mage this update was a removal of Kleptomania, which is now arcane only. This will make them worse into druid teams and into other mages, but that is pretty much a wash since they will be playing with druids anyway. On top of that, the Soulbind system is being expanded to include some new abilities, and for Night Fae mages, that means Waking Dreams, which will give them an auto-proc defensive to offset the lack of Cauterize. Venthyr Frost mages will have Fatal Flaw as their end cap ability, which gives them 20% versatility after Euphoria ends. Making its way up the tier list this season is Destruction Warlock, who moved up from B tier since our last update. The main reason for this includes a spec-wide buff to Chaos Bolt damage by 10% with some other PvE-focused damage increases. In PvP though, Focused Chaos has been removed and now Chaos Bolt will passively deal 40% more damage in PvP. What this means is that Destro will be getting an entire new PvP talent option since Focused Chaos was pretty much mandatory in Arena. And this is overall a good thing because freshly added PvP talents, including Bonds of Fel, which will trap players in an AoE ring for 6 seconds unless they want to take a massive hit of fire damage directly to the face. And Shadow Rift, which will cause enemy players to be ported to their demonic circle, which is super cool looking, not gonna lie. Having a new PvP talent opened up is like having an entire new ability, and considering the buffs to Frost Mages and Feral Druids, Destro Warlocks are looking pretty good for Season 2 since they will probably have multiple Tier 1 comps this patch. The last spec that might make bigger waves in Season 2 are Affliction Warlocks, who haven't been well represented at all so far in Shadowlands. Some key buffs include damage increases to most of their instant cast damage, which will be a huge boost to their throughput considering they have limited globals to actually cast in Arena. This comes with a rework to the infamous Corruption Slow Legendary, which no longer passively snares targets, but instead will refresh curses every time Corruption ticks. Although people were happy to see the snare portion go away, this new version might be even more broken, as Corruption Ticks will be able to refresh Curse of Weakness, Curse of Tongues, and Curse of Exhaustion as long as Corruption stays up. In any case, Affliction might find itself a niche role in the meta, especially considering the strength of Assassination Rogues, Feral Druids, Warriors, and Mages going to Season 2. The B tier is where things get really interesting, since the remaining specs will all be pretty new to Arena in 9.1. Demo Warlock is one example, and we really haven't seen it played much in competitive Arena so far. Its main weakness is that it has to ramp up its damage, giving it a slow start in a meta where snappy, fast cooldowns are generally preferred. 9.1 introduces a new PvP talent called Fell Obelisk, which gives you and your minions a massive damage increase while active. This comes with a change to the existing Call Fell Lord PvP talent, but these two talents will have to compete with one another since Demo Warlock PvP options are super limited. This is on top of a really niche class-wide addition of Shadow Rift, which will beam enemy players onto your teleport when used. And again, this is a really flashy option that might see a lot of play in RPGs. Overall, it's really hard to gauge whether or not Demo will be able to compete with its other two specs, who are seeing massive buffs this patch. Demonology will likely be competitive, but just not nearly as consistent as some of the high tiers on this list. The same can be said about Arcane Mage, who is also moving up to the B tier from the trash bin of Season 1. Fundamentally, Arcane is a rather gimmicky spec, where its main issue is that its damage and CC is all tied to one spell school. This makes it hard to manage interrupts, especially since it doesn't have a reliable AoE CC like Dragon's Breath to set up polymorph casts. 9.1 gives Arcane Mages some more damage on Arcane Blast, and a new PvP talent entirely called Arcanosphere, which does massive damage after a long channeled cast, which, by the way, can be used during invisibility. These new talents come on top of the Arcane exclusive Kleptomania, which was removed from Frost and Fire, giving Arcane a unique tool specifically to counter its other specs, along with being able to strip Resto Druid hots. These changes together will definitely make Arcane more popular, as it will begin to attract Frost and Fire refugees, and although it won't be as strong as alternatives, it still remains a gimmicky threat even at higher ratings. Finishing off our Season 2 ranged DPS tier list is Marksmanship Hunter, who took a massive fall from grace since the beginning of the expansion. Just like the other Hunter specs, Marks is getting a complete rework to some of its existing class-wide PvP talents, including the new Tranquilizing Darts, Chimeral Sting, and Wild Kingdom that we covered for Beast Mastery. As far as spec-specific talents, there was only one new addition with Consecutive Concussion, which will cause Concussive Shot to stun targets for 4 seconds when Steady Shot is used 3 times. This is a really weird and somewhat clunky stun mechanic, as it will require using 4 separate globals just to stun a target for 4 seconds. Of course, this will give another option for landing traps, but it requires too much setup for very minimal reward. Marks will still have value in PvP, just nowhere near the value of BM or Survival, who are set to be powerhouses in Season 2. Expect to see familiar comps like Jungle Cleave and possibly even Hunter Shadow Priest as potential comp options in 9.1. Here we have a complete picture of our forecast for Season 2. Once again, BM Hunters and Fire Mages are probably here to stay, but they will be challenged by Shadow Priests and Elemental Shamans in the highest tier. Shadow Priest is going to be really hard to predict since its relative power level didn't change much, but it will still be an important utility bot for many 3s rosters, especially since it has one of the most unique and consistent win conditions in the game with Silence and Psychic Horror. The A tier specs are still really good and will have a role in a wide variety of comps since the control of Balance Druids, Frost Mages, and Warlocks allow these specs to fit into multiple comp archetypes. The B tier is honestly a bit chaotic, and none of these specs were remotely popular at the end of Season 1, so it will take some time to see how they fit into the new meta. And that concludes our prediction for ranged DPS in Season 2. This will likely be one of the most memorable seasons of all time, since many classes are getting huge reworks. We will be updating you with a healer tier list in the next few days, so be sure to subscribe with all notifications turned on so you don't miss out. If you're looking to increase your rating this season, be sure to check out skillcap.com/wow, where we will be updating all of our courses and adding new commentaries for 9.1. As always though, thanks for watching.